speaking of to anything, and he'll say it.
Even oh!
Oh!
Welcome, everybody, to another episode of The Wanger Show. This is episode 140. Trace, 143.
I'm sorry?
143.
Thank you. Oh, my God.
You're so white.
Man, I had no idea what you were saying.
What's it like?
It's pretty great, guys.
It's awesome. One day I'll get there.
They're the human de-evolution.
It's the best. All you got to worry about is guilt, and that's about it.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I can do with that.
That's no problem. Mm-hmm. Welcome back, everybody. We're here. Cody's back.
I'm back, guys.
Cody was gone last week.
Mm-hmm.
Our good friend Eric Striffel was on. That was a great episode. That was a very long episode, and I didn't realize how long it was.
I love the comment. I think it was on the Discord. They're like, I need a cigarette every time Eric's on the show.
Just to, like, chill out.
Yeah.
Like,
Jesus.
Oh, he's my favorite. I'm so glad we got to hang out. I hope I get to hang out with him sometime this week. What the fuck was that?
It's still
that
playing.
Part of the playlist?
It's still playing, yeah.
Patreon, $1. $1. So that last week was really fun, and Amber was actually listening to the episode, and she's like, when are you guys getting to the fucking Dr. Sleep review?
Because
we didn't get into
funny.
It for a while.
Yeah. That was good.
So we spoiled that shit, and we're spoiling Knives Out tonight, so no, I'm kidding.
I hope you've seen it.
Are you going to see it, Brian?
I want to see that one.
Yeah?
I have three that I want to see by the end of this week.
All right. Let's do the power rankings here. Number three.
Number three.
What's the third one that you want to see by the end of the week, Brian?
Ford v. Ferrari.
Ooh, I almost saw that yesterday.
That's definitely a movie that's out right now.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Brian, what's your number two?
My dad really wanted to see that movie.
All dads ever wanted to see
that
movie. Yeah.
I wish I had one.
Oh, man.
Number two is, I would say, Knives Out.
Yes, okay.
Oh,
yes.
Boy.
What's number one? Okay, Jojo Rabbit. No, you saw that already. How about, Honey Boy?
Nah, I don't really care to see that.
Well, I don't care about you.
Did you see that one?
I do want to.
You
want
to see it?
Yeah.
That's the one about Shia LaBeouf's life.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. His name's Shia LaBeouf, and he's a great actor.
I mean,
Peanut Butter Falcon. I need to fucking watch
that. I saw
it's
that.
Streaming. Yeah?
I saw it over the weekend. It's really good.
It's good? Yeah. I don't like peanut butter. Is that going to be okay?
No.
Oh.
No, it'll be fine. Okay. I don't understand what I was doing there.
I don't like falcons.
Is there a falcon that they put?
That's where it crosses.
I'm afraid
the line.
Of. I'm afraid of birds.
Be a falcon fan.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Number one is Parasite. You guys said.
Oh yeah.
I want to see
Parasite's
that.
Fucking great.
Yeah. Mm.
Big fan of that movie.
Those are the top three.
Those are Brian's power rankings of movies.
I almost went to see Ford before yesterday, but I'm fighting a sickness. So,
but you drive a Honda. What am I doing? What am I doing? I don't know.
I don't even drive a Honda.
I don't know what you drive. I drive a Honda. Cody and I drive a Honda. You drive a
Toyota.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go.
It's the worst, best joke you've ever done.
I'll take it. I had a worse joke a few weeks ago, like a month or so ago. I forget what it
you
was.
You have a lot of bad ones. But
oh, yeah, I know.
Going up to them.
The worst, best one. I'll take it. I'll fucking take it. You gotta take more. You're gonna, you know.
That's all I got.
That's
to
it.
See.
Okay.
I know. I want to see Us. That's on HBO now.
Haven't seen Us?
I still haven't seen that.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. It's good. Not great.
Yeah.
Awards fine. Contenderish.
Nah.
Not awards contenderish.
Maybe Lupita.
Lupita's good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because that's a. Oh. Have you not gotten spoiled?
No,
I almost spoiled
some
shit.
What he's trying
I don't
to
know.
Say.
No, don't say.
Okay.
I haven't heard anything.
Okay.
Anything
okay.
About
yeah.
It.
Yeah. I could see that. I can definitely see that.
Okay.
Yeah. You know
she
why?
Plays two characters, Cody.
Yeah.
Oh well. Fuck. There you go.
Okay. He knows that.
I didn't know that.
That's the whole premise of the movie.
Okay. Fine.
I didn't want to know they were doppelgangers.
Yeah.
Shit.
Well, that I didn't. Okay.
What else? I think that's it. That's it.
That's all
it. Ford v. Ferrari. Because James Mangold, Wolverine, he's good.
Yeah.
That's all I know him from.
He did.
Night and Day starring Tom Cruise.
Not
he did that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
Not Walk Hard.
Walk the Line.
Oh, he did that?
Yeah, he did that one.
That's cool. I remember
to Yuma.
He did that one. I love 3:10 to Yuma.
It's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
It's a remake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you guys guess what time I saw that movie?
About 4:45.
No, like 5:00.
Should we start over? What's going on, guys?
I have no idea. It's our gobble gobble turkey day.
Gobble gobble breath.
It's where we celebrate.
As you can see on the marquee, I ran out of peas.
Yeah, it looks a little weird.
Eddie's
upside down peas.
Why'd you have to
gobble gobble?
Oh,
it seemed like it really worked.
Bruh,
that bruh.
Gobble gobble, bruh.
But then again, if I just had no bra in there. I would have one capital B and a lowercase b. That'd look even weirder.
That'd be weird.
Yeah.
So I was like, what am I going to do with this extra B? I don't know. Let's go with bruh.
Bruh.
It's a thing kids say. Bruh.
That's what they say?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bruh.
Mm.
Brian's yeah, looking for his bruh soundbite, I think.
Damn it. You knew. Remember I had one?
Yeah. I knew
you're
bored.
Got them all. You're so good with those buttons. You hit those buttons and you just get me.
Bruh.
Brian, no, you please.
Brian, you watching Watchmen?
No, I'm not.
Oh, my God. Let's talk about some racist shit, man.
Watchmen is fucking dope.
That's so fucking...
That show is amazing.
What'd you say today? Like, they're going to teach this?
They're going to teach this shit in college.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah.
Really?
Teach this directly. Really?
Because college is full of lefties, little bubbles in there, all that shit. That's why.
Maybe they're not going to teach us in Alabama, Brian, but they're going to teach us in film schools.
Film court.
Film courses is what I was trying to say.
Order! Hey, you finish your report first.
It's a good episode, so I'm trying to say.
The direction and writing.
Let me fucking talk. The direction and writing are just spectacular in this episode.
Here's the line.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Acting, you can learn about acting from this episode.
Oh, my goodness. Really?
Oh,
so even good. Techniques. Filmed the way they shot this episode.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I don't know how they fucking did half the shit.
There was a lot of, not like super long takes, but there weren't a lot of cuts. Like, just, we'd enter a scene. It wouldn't be like typical AB. It'd just be a camera like here, and then it panned back to this person.
Floating around.
Oh, it's it's great.
But you had never seen Wonders before?
We had, but this was like, not this, yeah, like what he said, it wasn't like they were long takes. They were just like complex takes.
Yeah.
Where they would be moving around and there'd be so much going on and they'd move it back and then the room's completely different than it was before.
The context of the story. Yeah.
I know a lot of it's probably cutting. Visual effects and they're cheating and all that stuff. But as a viewer, you're like, what the fuck? It's amazing. Mm-hmm.
It's very powerful. There's some deep shit going on.
Yeah.
Racial.
Love it.
Gender. Mm-hmm. Sexuality. All of it.
I love it either.
It's fucking great. It's really good.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Go watch it. Who watches The Watchmen? We do.
We do. It's a... Thank you. Thank you.
It's been a minute, man.
Thank you. Thank you.
You didn't like that one?
Hmm?
It's been a minute, man.
Oh, that was good. Did you say men or man?
I say man, but...
Men would have been...
It's a stretch.
Saying men is a weird word, though. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, because we're fucking scumbags.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, hey, men. I don't know.
What's up, boys?
Doesn't work.
Mm.
Yeah, didn't
you fedora wearing scrub lords.
Okay.
All right.
What was the title of that soundbite?
Fedora wearing scrub lords.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. That makes a lot of sense.
You fedora wearing scrub lords.
Okay.
It's probably a reference to something I don't know.
Okay. I did finish the podcast too.
The HBO one.
Yeah, he mentioned the candles. And I was like, oh fuck.
I did hear that. Like he got his
which
candles
like moment. Like. I love how they when they talk about stuff on that we're talking about like the official Watchmen podcast with Craig Mazin and Damon Lindelof, and they just like break down all the episodes. I love how they just nonchalantly talk about stuff. It's just like, oh yeah, that's a thing. Meanwhile, we're like theorizing, speculating. We're like, this means this, and it's like, oh yeah, of course. And of course, the candles. I'm like, oh well, I thought that was like a big deal.
I brought that up on live. I was like, there's this theory that Christian came up with about these candles, and I said about the timeline, and all that. Like, oh yeah, that was confirmed, and I'm like. All right.
Well, way to suck the fun.
Yeah.
More like Collider, suck the fun. Live. I don't know. Who was that? Darina?
No.
Queen of Death.
Roxy said that one.
Oh, damn it.
Brian, what are we doing here? What's this one?
Some Enchanted Evening. Watchmen.
Probably played.
It's from the score.
Yeah.
Okay.
They released that part too. They released the first section.
I haven't listened to any of it yet. Okay. I've just listened to what's on the. What's on the telly?
Well, not, oh, you haven't even gotten the Spotify one.
No.
Oh.
I don't know. I'm waiting for the thing to end.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're better than me?
I am.
Okay.
Guys, I figured out I can listen to put on headphones while I'm watching this and don't have to worry about waking up the kid.
Oh.
That was an issue before. I'd have to watch everything at such low volume.
Well, Marissa doesn't watch it, right?
Or no.
She okay.
She wanted to, then I watched it without her to start. She got really mad at me, and I think... The show just really puts us both in a bad mood.
Well, yeah. Is she into
the racial tensions? Is that
it's
why?
It's gotta be. Yeah, the white guilt that we both have.
Yeah.
It's like just really uncomfortable for us to watch. You know?
Oh, it just, I don't want to spoil anything, but the fact that, this is from the first episode, the baby, like, Will being put in like a basket, both of his parents put in, like, and then him, Damon Lindelof referencing that to like Superman.
Yeah.
Like that's his parents sending him up.
It's good shit. good shit. They know what they're doing on this show.
They know what the fuck.
There's nothing on the show that's like, oh, we didn't mean for that. Like, everything is so intentional.
Everything's planned out.
Yeah,
are you kind of worried that you're going to be disappointed by the end?
I don't care if I am, because the first two thirds of this have just been so much fun. It's the journey, not the conclusion that matters.
Game of Thrones.
Okay. Sure.
Yeah.
Or even Lost for that matter.
This one's
it's about, Lost. Oh, this is a good one. It's about the ride that you take to get there. All right.
Dude,
no one likes something ending. You know
I
mean?
Listened to the score that Atticus and, what the fuck? Atticus and Ross? Is it Atticus Ross?
Same guy.
Same guy. Trent. There you go. Trent. Yeah, there you go. I always want to say Atticus Fish. I fucking put the shit on Spotify, and it just makes me want to, like, what did I say? Like, get in a car and drive away?
I want to, like, hack into a fucking national security thing right now. Just like, yeah. Just down a fucking... come on,
Brad. That's what the Social Network gives me. But...
Yeah.
Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. We played that one last week. Yeah. So it's a great show. Watchmen. Check it out. You should watch
it. It's only five episodes in?
Six.
Six.
Oh, yeah. Six.
There's only three left.
There's nine total.
Nine total. Have not announced a season two. Don't do it. Keep it one. They're going to announce season two at some point.
You're the one that doesn't like any...
I don't like any shows going beyond. Maniac's like one of my favorite shows ever.
He just doesn't ever want to be let down by anything.
Yeah.
Like, just let it go. Just let it stay. Let it be good. Come on.
It all depends. You know?
Did Walter White break bad? Who cares?
Yeah. Very surprised me.
Season two
is fucking... might even be better than season one.
So you're wrong.
Well, I'm just saying. You know, Walking Dead, if it was just one season, that would have been great.
That would have been.
That would have been.
Yeah.
Wonderful season. It's a bad example, but I'm just saying. you guys see any other movies this weekend or anything? Nothing?
No. Oh, I had another movie that I need to see this weekend.
Oh, so there's four.
The Irishman comes out.
Oh yeah. I got to set aside.
On the Netflix.
18 hours to go see that movie.
Yeah.
Gonna have those headphones on for a long time to watch that one.
You got
to
see that one. Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to hurt.
That's going to hurt my ears.
After a while, that's going to hurt.
You see someone tweet about, like, you know what an Irish goodbye is?
Yeah, you just take
fart?
It's
no.
That was a thing.
No.
You fart and leave?
No. Irish goodbye is just
never
like,
heard that. I don't know if that was called an Irish goodbye, but I'm just
it's
saying.
It's like, that's crop dusting.
Oh, crop dusting. That's what it is.
Irish goodbye. Oh, the Irish are known for their crops.
It's only the Irish that fart and walk away. How dare you?
It even smells like you're from Ireland. It's crazy.
I'm sorry. So Irish goodbye is something that I do a lot, actually. I try to leave without...
You have a great excuse now that you have a kid.
Yeah.
You can just fucking... Oh, kid's sick.
You know who's the best at it?
Mark Ellis
is great.
The best.
It'll be 20 minutes later. You're like, is Ellis still here?
He's like a ghost. Mm-hmm. He just disappears.
He did not do that at...
Typical Irish guy.
He did not do that at Ken and Grace's party, though.
I think
he stuck around. I think we left before he did.
Yeah, he stayed there. Mm-hmm. We said goodbye to him. It was super awkward.
Didn't know what
to do. Go for
a
hug.
Soup sock.
Handshake.
No, I don't hug anybody.
I was like, give him fist bumps. Sometimes we give him a hug.
I still have traumatizing nightmares of our awkward hug that we had at the day after my wedding.
Who
told
did?
You about this?
Oh, wait. The day after I stumbled into the buffet. So buffet.
It's like 7 in the morning or some shit. And we're leaving to go hop on a plane. And Brian's just like, hey, man. He's just got like 4 water bottles with him. He's getting like eggs and shit. And then I'm like, all right, I'm going to go take off. Going to go up and go to the airport. And he's like, all right. It's like the most awkward hug ever. I'm like, all right, thanks, buddy. Thank you.
Still probably drunk at that time.
Oh, my God. That's fucking funny.
That was great. That was the last person that I talked to before I left.
Before Ireland. There you go.
The Irish goodbye. I did an Irish goodbye.
That's where you learned it. Yeah. It comes full circle.
Oh, man. That's funny. That's funny stuff. Brian, we were playing a game. Yeah. On the Patreon section of the show.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I don't know the origins, but we were guessing a bunch of really bad songs from the early 2000s.
Mm.
And Brian, explain yourself.
Okay. So you guys aren't watching Silicon Valley?
The new
Not
season?
Currently. The new season.
I haven't watched like the past 2 episodes.
Okay.
I'm a little bit. I didn't like the first episode
as
much, but the second episode kind of got me back. Anyways.
Yeah, it's back. It's funny. It's great again. Spoilers.
Oh, what's his name comes back?
Russ comes back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I do know
great.
That guy.
I love that character.
He's putting on Russ Fest.
Yeah.
In the show?
In the show. So he's going to put on Russ Fest. And there's a whole website like rustfest.net or something like dedicated to this. And they have a Spotify playlist.
And this is it?
This is the Spotify.
Oh, that's incredible.
It's Russ Fest.
Oh.
And so the next episode is when it's going to happen.
Okay.
It's looking like the Fire Fest.
Oh, okay.
It's going to be expensive and all that shit. And I don't know what's going to happen.
Because they're the opening episode. They did like the Facebook hearing, the Mark Zuckerberg hearing, which was cool. Yeah.
So they're all like always current with the topics and everything. So yeah. Russ is coming. And also today, I don't know if today, but I've been trying to go to like every liquor store. The Tres Comas. Tres Comas. That's a real liquor.
Oh,
that's
really? You're trying to look for it.
Yeah.
Oh.
I called BevMo. They said they'll get it next week, maybe.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Just imagine you calling these places. Hi, I was wondering if you had the, what's it called?
I call it Tres Comas.
Not even going to try to pronounce that.
But no, you're supposed to say Tres Comas.
Tres Comas.
Tres, like it.
Tres.
I can't roll
my
R's.
You're not licking it.
I can't roll my R's.
Just do that.
Tres.
Can't do it.
Like sorry. Andres?
Andres. I can't do it.
That one's always hard. I always get lazy and I say Andres. Sorry.
Yeah, I say Andres.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Anyway, there's new tequilas out.
Thank God you saved us from
I was trying to get it today so we can take shots of Tres Comas today.
I want
three liquor stores, no go.
This is why Thanksgiving is such a great week. I just want to drink all week long and bitch to my family.
I do that every week.
Oh, it's always to your child. Mm-hmm. Just, Grant.
Let me tell you why the world sucks, Grant.
Yeah. The child's like, I'm one.
The fuck you are from me, Dad. You're expecting too much of me already.
I didn't ask to be here.
Is he going to have like a nickname for you, like Pa or?
No.
No?
Papa. Yeah, no.
Like in the 1920s?
Just Dad.
Dad. Oh, God damn it,
I told
Dad.
You guys about my grandparents' issue.
No.
All my parents and Marissa's parents all want to be called a different name instead of Grandma and Grandpa.
Yeah, why? Gammy, Nana.
Because I don't want to confuse. I'm sorry. Freaking kids all the time have multiple grandparents. Okay, they're not going to be confused. Yeah. But it's stupid. So I
call all my grandmas different names.
Well, you call them by I call them by their name, like grandma.
Oh, yeah, grandma something.
Name, yeah. Oh, interesting. Right?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
You don't do that.
Actually, I don't call any of my grandmas grandma.
Are you Irish?
Why do they not? Come
back to the Irish farts. Things. It's clearly not.
No,
Irish.
I call my grandma
every
my,
time you leave a room
on my. I really wish we were in a real conversation when that happened.
Yeah.
Just like, what? No, I call my grandma on my dad's side, Abuelita, or Abuela. Yeah. And then my Mexican side. And then on my mom's side, I call her Nan, because her mom was Nana, and then she's like Nan.
Mm.
And then my mom
non-Mexican side, you call her Nan.
They're both Mexican side.
Are they? Yeah. Seems like it's in the name. Just saying.
I call her Nan. It's a name.
So this game, bro.
Yes. Don't white-splain me, bro.
No, so this is the Rust Fest playlist on Spotify.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like,
so we're just trying to guess all these shitty bands.
Well, it's all the bands from like the 90s. Like in the show, like he listens to Papa Roach, Last Resort, and all that shit. And then he just has a playlist of everything. So you guys are guessing what the next one is.
All okay. Right, here we go,
here's
here
the
we
next one. Wait, let me see if I can play it.
Your name is your buzzer.
Can I test the buzzers?
We already did this joke for the
recycled the joke. I want to make sure everyone got the showdown joke that we were doing.
All right, fine. All right, they're not funny people.
Mm. Cody.
Fuck.
It's Limp Bizkit. I don't know the fucking name of the song.
It's
Mission Impossible 2.
Yes, yes. Yeah,
but what's the song name? It's on the title. Full title.
It's not my generation. It's, fuck, I don't have it.
Do you know it's Christian?
It's actually got a nice.
Am I allowed to listen to it?
None of you guys know it.
Impossible Mission. I have no
idea.
What is it?
It's called Take a Look Around.
Oh, I knew that. I knew that.
What a piece of shit. Come on, Cody.
All right, sorry, go on.
Oh, that's good.
Christian?
Cody. Christian.
You know it. Come on, buddy.
Is it POD?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, New Generation? Youth of a Nation. Excuse me, Youth of a Nation.
I think Cody got the song point.
New Generation, you fucking idiot.
It takes a while to kick in. Wait, I just want to hear the bass go. Dong. I got hard. I don't know if you got hard. I got hard.
This table is a little bit higher. Christian! Chop Suey's This Move Down. How is that on his playlist? That's a great song.
It's Rust Fest.
Okay, but
it came out during the time.
Okay, but good song should be on the list.
Yeah. Well, Take a Look Around is pretty good.
All right, fine. Fair enough. Christian! Okay, it's Queens of the Stone Age, but it's, fuck.
They don't say the name of the song.
No, it's not.
They do?
They say it multiple times.
Little Sister. No, it's not Little Sister. No. Fuck, no. I already guessed, sorry.
Dun, 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 dun. What the fuck's the name of that one? It's the most popular song.
No, the most popular is Go With The Flow.
No, this is the most popular one. This is the one that got him on the map.
You sure?
Yeah. Pretty sure.
What? Where's the map? Let me see.
It's right next to Ireland. Come on, guys. I don't remember.
It's called No One Knows.
No one knows.
They do say it many times in the fucking song. We're not very good at this, guys. Oh, man. What's next? Cody. Come on.
Oh, fuck.
Come on.
I was looking at a text message.
What's my age again? Blink 182.
Band name?
Blink 182.
Small B.
Small B dash 182. Thank you.
Christian.
Oh, why did I fucking pull that?
This is a tougher one.
Who is this?
Oh. It's not.
We're getting yelled at by a lot of people in the comments right now.
This is an older song. It's not our generation.
No,
song.
I know, but
is it?
Fuck.
I would say early 90s.
Oh, I think I know. Is it Stone Temple Pilots?
No.
Fuck, I have no idea.
Alice in Chains.
Oh, God. Fuck. We're going to get destroyed. Of course it's Alice in Chains.
Man in the Box.
Yeah, I knew that one.
All right.
Oh, yeah! Jesus. I feel like if we had, like, multiple choice, then we could probably get it.
Yeah, there's no time for multiple choice.
We're going to need it. You have to come up with three other options.
Girl, you remember the music videos where it's, like, they're in motion, but it was, like, stutter? Or like fade in and out of each other.
Oh, yeah.
That was like the...
You know, had some dope-ass videos? Korn.
Oh, fuck yeah.
You remember that?
Dude,
Falling away from...
Issues just turned like 20 or something.
Oh, I had that CD.
Jonathan Davis tweeted about it. Happy birthday to That's Issues. Good stuff.
Fucking Issues.
Issues. If you have an issue, here's a tissue.
Ooh.
I don't think you guys know this one. Cody would surprise me if you knew it.
I don't think I know it. Nope.
You gotta hear the voice. I really hope these early 2000s 311? Bands don't flag us. No, you don't hear the little ska.
Bink, bink.
Oh, Christian? No. Not Audio Slave.
It's Close. Soundgarden. I don't know the name of it.
He just said the name real quick. Spoon Man.
Oh, okay. Spoon Man. I wasn't gonna get that. Yeah. Oh! Oh, no, keep playing.
Whatever. Oh, you didn't say it. Okay.
That's not live.
Yeah, it is.
It is? Oh, what's the name of the song?
He didn't say his name.
Oh, yeah.
Cody, live. oh, my God.
I don't know this. I've never heard this song.
I don't know the name of it. This song's amazing.
Let me go.
This is just music right here, guys.
It's called I Alone.
Mm.
It doesn't build up or anything? Oh. I
Alone.
I like the sound of the drums.
All right. Next.
Great stuff.
Christian.
Fuck.
I think that was Cody.
That was Nine Inch Nails.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fuck.
Yes, I know it. I know it.
I know how it goes.
Christian.
Oh, you guys are big Atticus Ross's fans, huh?
Mostly Trent.
What the hell is the name of it?
Animal.
No.
Oh, fuck. Really? I thought it was Animal.
No.
You bring me closer to God. Oh, Closer.
You just said
I got there, guys.
This
I
is
got
fuck
there.
You like an animal, though, right?
Yeah.
Oh, this is a song that says I want to fuck you.
That's why I thought it was called Animal.
Yeah. This song came on the radio a lot of times when I was in the car with my parents. And they awkwardly changed the station many times whenever it would come on.
Oh, this just won't do.
Let's see what's on 95.5 KLOS instead. How about that?
I love KLOS. KLOS
101.
Let's play some classic rock.
Let's play a little bit of Mark and Brian for
you. Yeah. Let's get this devil music out of here. This is really taking its time.
It
I almost
like
went
Wild
Def
Thing.
Leppard for a second.
It was like Hendrix.
I don't think I'm going to get this one.
Huh.
I don't think you guys get it.
Not happening. What is it, Brian?
Fast forward.
Oh! What the hell is this? All these songs blend together.
They do.
Velvet Revolver?
No.
It sounds like Puddle of Mud, but it's not.
It kind
of
does. This was on Guitar Hero,
yeah.
Wasn't it?
I don't know the name of it.
Stone Temple Pilot?
Oh, okay. Shit.
Vaseline.
Wasn't that the lead singer from Velvet Revolver?
Scott, I want to.
He passed away a few years
Sounds
ago.
Sounds super familiar. Is it Scott Weiland?
I think
the Stone Temple Pilots
guy
did.
Yeah. So that's, he was the lead singer of Velvet Revolver.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Because I remember Christian. Oh, sorry. This is Rage Against the Machine.
Come on.
It's Killing the Name of
Yes. Yeah. One of the best songs of all time.
Of all time.
Yes, I love Rage Against the
Machine. Aren't they coming back or something?
Just for a couple shows.
Like they're performing, like Zach De La Rocha is performing?
Yeah.
How do we not know about this?
We talked about it a while ago.
Oh, yeah, we were very excited.
Yeah, we weren't there.
No. This is on also Guitar Hero 2.
What's your favorite Rage Against the Machine song? Mine isn't this one, even though this is one of the best songs of all time. I have another one that's even better.
I kind of like Gorilla Radio, but
that's a good one.
Gorilla Radio's great.
I'm a Testify guy.
Testify.
Testify. Yeah. That song will get in the mood to just fucking take life by the horns.
Fucking, I love this song.
Yeah.
This song's heavy as fuck.
How does Testify go?
Or the beginning of
it? Just like,
it's right outside the door, now Testify. It's like the best riff ever. Yeah.
Christian. It's Red Hot Chili Peppers, and it is...
I'm right behind you, man.
Give it away.
Yep.
Give it away.
Had it.
Favorite Red Hot... Okay, I only listened to Red Hot up until Stadium Arcadium. I never listened to anything past that.
You didn't like them after that?
I just never, like Stadium Arcadium was like, whoa! And then after that I was just like,
double album.
Double album, yeah. That's two albums.
Performed that for like 2 years.
Can you name a song just off this? I think it's called like Charlie or something like that. I don't know. I have no idea. It's a good song though.
All right, what's next?
I like Fortune Faded by the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Stony Vine.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I like it.
Zephyr. I like Zephyr.
Ooh.
Cody knows it.
This is a John Carpenter score.
You guys know it. Play at home.
I'm going to feel like a fucking idiot.
You guys know it.
I'm waiting for it to start.
Now it's turning into Terminator. It's Blade Runner. Hold on.
Oh, Christian!
Oh, hold on.
That's one of us. That's one of us. Oh, God.
That was Christian.
His ball with the ball.
That is the best song of all time. Let's let that play through. Let's play that one through.
We played this during so many fucking Schmodown days. How did we not know this? Was it the music video version and it starts all longer?
Probably.
I don't know. This is just on
Spotify.
Wait for the
drop here.
An intro? Somebody had this as their intro?
No.
No one did. We played it all the time.
So, in Schmodown, there's always entrance music, right? And we had a speaker and a computer was connected to it. So, before every match, we would just start this song at the beginning every time.
I think Harlov got really mad.
He got really mad.
He realized what we were doing. He's kidding.
So we kind of like, is this when his shirt is like,
no mic? I'm like...
Kid Rock! Oh, man.
He says Kid Rock?
Yeah.
Well, he says my name is Kid Rock.
Oh, okay, fine. That's funny.
Great album.
What a great song. Man.
I don't know what album it's from, but...
It's the White Album.
That's from American Badass.
Oh, no.
No.
That was later.
No, it's not Cocky. It's the one... Fuck!
It's the question that...
No, some cowboy?
They're eating you up in the comments right now.
It's
Cowboys from Hell?
Pantera? No, I think... Well, because Cowboy
Redneck
was on
Redneck Cowboy, is that the name of it? I don't fucking know.
No.
Isn't he like a rich dude? Okay, whatever.
Christian, this is 311 Down.
Holy shit, you knew that?
Yeah.
Wow, good job, buddy.
Wow, look at that.
Chill. I love this song.
Oh my God, I've never heard Chase a 311 song.
Chase and Freddie, they all listen to 311 all the time.
Yeah. I've only heard Amber from 311.
I like that song.
And, I like Flowing. Flowing's a good song.
No, Amber was a remake.
I like that's a cover of.
They did a cover of The Cure.
Yeah, they did.
Amber was what's it called? The Police? Is that not Amber.
They did whenever I'm alone.
Yeah, that's The Cure.
Yeah, there you go. That was in 51st Dates. I remember that. Yeah.
I will always love you.
What's the name of the song?
I think it's I Will Always Love You.
Yeah. Beautiful Disaster is also a great song. That's the.
No, it's called Love Song.
Love Song.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Boom, 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 boom. No, you don't know that song?
That's like the third time you've done a bass riff expecting us
no,
to
No, that was a guitar.
Right.
Look up.
I'm even more confused. That sounded like
look
a bass.
Look up 311 Beautiful Disaster. You'll know exactly what song this is. They play this on the radio all the time.
I don't think I maybe. I don't think I've heard more than two 311 songs.
Chill.
It's like that episode of South Park when he's playing the Guitar Hero thing acoustic, and he's like, I love this song. We don't know what the hell you're playing here.
Wait, 311, what is it called?
Beautiful Disaster. Is what it's called.
Yeah. And Come Original is another one. Come Original. What the hell kind of band were they?
They were like a ska
rock. Like, yeah. You remember this song?
Oh, yeah. Da-na-na.
Yeah, this song's dope as fuck.
Yeah.
They will be in Nevada on March 11th.
Oh, yeah. Then there's the Dremel. Hold on.
All right,
what else we got?
Yeah, I should have gotten into them more.
We should have done more with our lives, guys. Listen to 311. Should have listened to more 311 back in the day.
Cody.
Is it Chevelle?
No.
Okay. Is it Seether?
No.
Is it 3 Days Grace?
No.
Damn it. Never mind.
What is it? I never heard of it. Collective Soul?
Oh, no. Never mind.
Where the River Flows.
Yeah, not good.
I never heard this one before.
No.
Christian.
Cody.
Christian.
Limp Bizkit.
Yeah.
You don't
know
those
songs.
Oh those days. Hey, give me time. I got 20 seconds.
You do not. That was never established.
Oh my God.
Cody. Justify.
No, Cody.
Oh, it's Break Stuff.
Oh, duh. Okay.
Break your fucking face tonight. It's just one of those days where you don't want to wake up. Everything is
Would you say that Fred Durst is the most influential figure in your life?
Probably.
On the album? Which album is this?
This was...
Break Stuff.
Significant Other.
Yeah. I love this album. Yeah. I had this CD.
Yeah. Do you remember on the next one, they had like an intro where it's like, yeah, Dad, what is it? And he's like, what is it? It's Limp Bizkit. And then like fucking song starts playing. It's terrible. It's a terrible start to an album.
Get the fucking face tonight!
And then he's on the car.
Yeah.
Are they going on like a massive tour
and
after?
Pauly Shores. Fucking 90s, man.
Were we gonna go try to see them like last year?
At
like,
the like Troubadours. That's right.
It was like a dollar troop. Show or something.
$3 show.
The Troops, yeah.
I don't know how it went, but whatever.
So besides Ba with the Ba, Adam would also play Roland by Limp Bizkit. But strictly the music video version where he gets the valet keys. He's like, all right, partner, keep on rolling, baby. You know what time it is. He goes like that. It's terrible.
Oh.
These songs really taking their time here.
This is a band I always say I hate.
You hate.
I just don't like them. I don't know why. I think Cody said he liked them.
Oh.
Oh, this is,
That?
That rooster thing? There comes the rooster. Oh. No?
I can. It's a 10-minute long song.
Christian.
Yeah. Oh, I fucking hate this band.
Tool?
I hate this band.
It's Tool? Yes. Okay, yeah. I don't know the song, but...
Why do you hate them? I don't know why
it
I hate
just
them.
It just angers me. Every time I hear it, it's like there's like a vice against my temples, and it's just like pushing against my head.
They're very experimental.
Is that what... They're experimental rock, but
they're
not like...
They're like progressive. Like progressive rock. But maybe I could be explaining that wrong, but...
But everyone else is like a fan of them, and then... Everyone's like, oh, Tool's coming back together. I'm like, every time they come on the radio, I hate it.
I like two songs. I like three songs. Three songs. I like Sober, Schism, and The Pot. Mm. Those are the only songs I really care
for. This sounds like a perfect circle. You remember that band?
I think that's because they're the same members.
Oh, is it?
I think so, actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I think it's like the same singer. I know that.
Definitely. Yeah, for sure.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Because... I also hate Perfect Circle. They're the same people.
Cody. That's Chili Peppers. I believe it's Suck My Kiss.
Suck My Kiss!
Cody. Everlast.
Bye.
No, Everlast is the name of the band.
Who?
What It's Like.
Yeah.
Yes. Nice. I'm on fire, guys.
You know you're...
Okay, don't have that one.
I don't know this one either.
Sounds like a fart.
There's a fart in the band name.
Shitheads? I don't know.
Fart balls?
Who is Butthole it? Surfers?
Oh.
Pepper?
Yeah.
Fall in love with life and drink it from a fountain that is pouring.
I don't know what that is.
Christian?
You guys know this song.
Is that Yellowstone?
No. Yellow.
Yellow card. Excuse me.
That was?
No.
Oh, yeah. Who is
it? It does sound like Yellow.
Yeah, right?
It sounds like way, way, way.
If you guys...
Stain?
Oh. I have heard this. Oh. Here's everything you want. Yeah. Here's everything. That's a good song.
That's the name of the that's the name of the song, Everything You Want.
I forget the band.
By Vertical Horizon.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know that one.
Oh, we're getting some deep cuts here.
I don't know these.
Okay.
Nope.
I got it. Oh! I have... No?
It's not Sum 41, is it?
Sounds like Unwritten Law or something like that.
Eve 6.
Oh, Eve 6!
You know them?
Think twice before you touch my girl! You know that song?
That's the song.
It is?
Yeah.
It's Think Twice?
This is Think Twice.
It's song title.
And on that note, oh my god.
Oh, that's incredible.
Somebody accidentally getting a song right.
I've never heard this song before.
Oh, it's...
Where do you hear these songs? Radio? Do they just all pop up on radio?
Ever.
You guys know this song?
Yes. Superman? No.
That is
same band.
That is Three Doors Down.
Three Doors Down.
Keep playing it. When I'm gone.
Yeah. You gotta get it.
Yeah, I had to really get in the mood for it. Yeah. I had to really place myself in there.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh,
Christian,
yeah.
Is this Korn Freak on the Leash?
Yeah.
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 There's a lot. There's a whole thing down
Shit,
there.
Shit, man.
That's What's hilarious.
Your favorite Korn album.
Oh, he was in the news like today.
Yeah, Marky McGrath. Yeah.
What did he do?
Someone paid him a cameo to break up with her boyfriend or something.
Oh,
like that. Yeah. I didn't watch the video, but
that's like
really
a good reason to use cameo.
Yeah,
I think just for your own self worth.
I hope it was something good. What'd you say?
I don't know.
I haven't watched the video, but could you imagine just be like, "Hey, it's Mark McGrath, and I fucked your bitch."
That would be awesome.
And like that's how he did it. Oh, that'd be great. I really hope that's what it is.
I'm going to try to look it up.
Yeah, talk about that. Yeah, we'll talk about yourself. Did you see anything Wednesday? I've been playing Jedi Fallen Order.
How was it?
The Star Wars game.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good shit. How far into it?
Only a couple planets. Like, the way it's set up, you you start the story.
Tatooine? Mustafar?
No.
Yavin 4?
Dathomir.
Oh!
Kashyyyk?
Dantooine?
You said that very proper.
Dantooine. I had to make sure people knew that I was saying Dantooine and not Tatooine.
Oh.
Yeah.
How could you scrub that up?
Oh, man.
No, it's really cool because it's like, oh, no poo. It's a spooky planet.
Halloween time in Naboo is
fucking
lit. Naboo.
Mustafar. How far is Mustafar? I don't know. Yeah, it's cool. There's like some open world
From
shit.
Band, you go-
no, keep going.
Off the charts, but always in your hearts. And this cameo was booked by Cheyenne, and she wants
already.
You to know a few things. And this is a little difficult for me to say because it's the first one of these I've done.
He sounds like a Double Dare host.
But she wants you to know that you mean a lot to her.
Oh,
you mean the world to her. But she's having difficulty staying in this
long. Could you imagine being the guy getting this?
I don't know if I'd be mad.
I'd be laughing.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
It's like, holy shit, Mark McGrath broke up with me.
How long were they dating for?
I don't know.
Arguments, the biggest, you know, obstacles in our relationships is the distance between us. It makes it very
pretty
difficult.
Cool.
How much did she pay for that?
I don't know.
And it's hard.
So why does he have a cameo?
To let you know, Brady, that
Sugar Ray's not selling out stadiums anymore.
I guess not.
They fucking should be.
This relationship.
I'd go.
All around the world. Hold, and she still wants
it doesn't say how much, but apparently it was a joke.
Oh, that's not as cool.
That takes
now.
Away the fun.
Yeah. I wish you wouldn't have told me that.
All right.
Anyways.
How's Star Wars going?
Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah.
You get a
More like
Nub
Boomer.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, Nub Boomer. Was that a real laugh?
Yeah, it was.
That sounded like a fake laugh.
That was actually good. cocaine a boomer.
Oh
yeah, we're doing it. We're gangbusters the show today, guys. Whew,
I hope you're a fan of early 2000 shit rock. I wouldn't have it any other way. I would not. Oh my
In
goodness!
In 2 years, you're gonna look back on this episode. Oh, and be like, remember so we were fucking happy.
I'm gonna do what I've been doing and be doing the same shit I'm doing now. Just going through YouTube and be like, ah, oh, I was so much happier then, and I hate myself. Anyways,
good game?
It's a good game. Yeah, I haven't beaten it, but
is it canon?
Is it canon? Yeah, I think so.
Okay,
there's some cool shit that pop up. It's actually kind of fucking hard at first. You actually like you can't
you
just
suck.
Go.
You just suck at the game.
But it's great because I had to like learn how to fucking learn around how all these different enemies and how they work and stuff. And it's cool. Like you block and you can't just go and slash your way through shit. You have to block, 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 and then attack, attack, attack. Hmm. There's all these different moves. It's cool. You're not like an invincible Jedi. Okay.
So yeah. Brian, thoughts?
This is a video game for PS4.
That concludes 4. Brian's review of Jedi Fallen Order.
Yeah,
that's
good. Check it out now. Get the bundle.
Really well made.
We haven't talked about the Pokemons on the show.
Oh, no.
Brian,
you want to talk about this?
We had it ready. Look.
It's a pretty good game,
There's a lot of people that fucking hate this game.
I don't understand.
Nintendo's lazy. There's only 400 Pokemon.
As if you guys actually got the whole Pokedex. I don't believe you guys. And I'm a completionist. I get all of it. No, you fucking don't.
I get all of them. I get the shinies, and I have them. Fuck.
Yeah.
What?
You don't have your Pokemon heaven, of course. That's not what happened.
I'm having a blast.
Yeah.
I'm having a blast.
I take my time through all these cities. I go through every door. I'm like, I gotta check. I gotta explore this shit.
I still love that you can go into someone's house and just be like, and just grab some pussy. You know, that's what you do in these games.
There's one town where like you go in there and there's a bunch of guys who are just sitting on their couch depressed. And you're like, what's up, buddy?
So it's this show.
Basically
the show.
Hi, I wanted to give you this TM because I can't use it.
my wife says
my Pokemon left me. I can't use this TM anymore. Here's Slash.
Dude, there's some like subtle like sexual undertones in these games,
like
too.
Yeah, like what?
I don't know. Just like I get vibes, you know?
Yeah, what kind of vibes?
From your mom.
Like you get rock hard.
Oh, no, your mom.
Your mom.
I love that she's called a mom.
Yeah, mom.
Hey, mom.
Yeah.
And then hop.
I saw Telly one time. They're like,
the telly.
Yeah, I watch matches on the telly. It's great. It's great. It's such a British game. Fantastic.
It very much is. Yeah. I'm a big fan of it.
By British, I mean like it's just doing strictly British stereotypes.
Yeah.
Telly and mom.
But it's fine because it's not racist.
Of course. Yeah.
Yeah. Clearly. It's totally cool.
It's white.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's good. Yeah. I'm having a good time.
Anyway.
That's on the Switch?
On the Switch.
Oh, okay. The Switch.
You guys don't play online anymore, right?
No, but I still pay like $4 a month for that.
Do you really?
I stopped.
Don't. Yeah, I stopped
probably
doing
canceled mine.
Yeah, okay.
Just holding out hope for that Mario Party that we're doing, guys.
Oh, yeah, that didn't pan out.
Waiting room
we shot a whole
myself.
Video for that, and I never cut it. It's just sitting there.
Happens.
Maybe someday.
Frank, sorry about you guys that. Still talk to Frank? Does he still play?
Not as much. Man.
No, he ditches us for other people.
He's kind of big-timing us now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he is, mm-hmm. Huh? Is he?
Yeah, cuts a few deepfake videos, think he's too good for the Wangers.
Yeah, Frank. He's a fake friend, is what he is.
That's not true at all. I'm just kind of just saying this to piss
him off.
I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, we haven't talked to him.
He's trying to hit you up.
Not really.
Let's give him a call.
Ever since, should we call him?
If you think.
Call him and see what happens.
I haven't heard from Frank in a month.
He hasn't really talked to us.
No, ever since he cut his hair.
That is what it was. Mm-hmm. He cut his hair to try to be more dignified.
I noticed how short?
Like mine, I would say.
I'm calling him now.
Maybe a little bit longer than mine.
Mm-hmm.
Are you though?
Nope, so.
Like we do this every time.
He is. Fucking first try, bitch.
He's not gonna answer.
Probably at like
he's probably working.
Macy's again.
He's not
that delayed ring. That
was
that delayed ring. You think you have it on ring
it.
Too?
He knows exact. Hello.
Yeah. What's up?
Hey, what's up, Frank?
Hi. What's going on?
Hey, man. No, I just wanted to ask you a question because I'm at work right now. I'm editing these videos, and I just had a quick question for you.
Oh, yeah.
Are you here, by the way?
I'm not.
Oh, man. I thought I saw your door open. No, Cody wanted to ask you something.
I'm like, the Wangers. I got scared.
Hey, no, I'm not calling on the Wangers.
I'm not either.
Oh, okay.
I'm just also wanting to see how you're doing, Frank. Is everything good?
Son of a bitch.
Frank, we were just talking shit about you, and we were just like really missing you.
Why don't you talk to us anymore?
Yeah, you don't hang out with us anymore. Frank. You're like Brian, like is just praising you the world here.
He really wasn't. But Brian, do you want to say anything to Frank?
Where you been, Frank?
Where'd you go?
Sorry, guys.
Aww.
B, I miss you.
I think he's faking like the phone call breaking up.
Is he underwater? What's going on with the phone?
I didn't know there was an A.
Scuba diving right now, Frank.
You're on C.
Who's a better guest on the Wangers, me or Doreen?
At that point, we don't care anymore.
Yeah, I don't really care.
Yeah.
It depends, Frank.
Yeah.
Who's got the better show?
What does it depend on?
Oh!
Oh, that's right.
Shocker!
That's what happened.
What a fucking twist. Oh, boy.
What do you know? They're together.
Hey, Frank. Frank.
What's the topic of today's discussion?
Frank, have you played the new Pokemon game?
I have not.
You haven't even got it.
Christian filled me in. No, I've not had time. I think I'm taking a little break from Pokemon.
Oh,
whoa!
Pokemon Go kind of wiped me out.
What did Dorina do to you, dude?
Are you just like growing up on us here, Frank? What's going on, Frank?
Are you guys talking shit about me again?
No.
You're taking our friend away from Pokemon, Dorina.
Ow. What? Don't blame me because Frank doesn't want to play Pokemon. I played Tetris 99 the whole time, and I don't care.
Oh, you nerd.
Nobody cares.
Okay.
What? Tetris is nerdier than Pokemon?
Yeah, like fitting those shapes in those blocks?
No, definitely not.
When are we all playing Mario Party
Tetris
together?
The Tetris theme song is better, so Pokemon is nerdier.
Yeah, when are we going to play Mario Party together, right, Frank?
Frank, do you still have the online Nintendo thing?
I do, but Mario Party Online was the worst.
Oh, that's true.
Maybe they updated it. Who knows?
They really? No, they let us down.
But when are we going to get together and play as a whole?
We all bought a $60 game so we can play that shit. It's the saddest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Well, Frank, you know, we'll let you go.
See you next.
We really wanted to talk to our friend.
I'm free next week, Frank.
Hey, Brian, you want to go to Macy's with me next week?
I can
They're
do that.
Their annual winter sale.
Black Friday sale?
I mean, some people call it that. We're kind of steering away from that in 2019. But.
All right, Frank, we'll let you go. And Dorina, too. We miss you. We wish you would hang out with us more instead. But, you know, what are you going to do? Shit happens.
Fine. Miss you, buddy.
It's the only one I like.
Love you guys.
Bye, Frank. Bye, Dorina.
Adios.
Adios. Hijo.
Cody. Hans.
Thank God that's over.
Oh, my God. Right. Woof. What do you think?
Brian just kills me with this. It's the only one I like.
That's good shit. Oh, fuck, man. That was great. We talked
to our friend for the first time in weeks.
And
guys work with him.
Every day, he's just across really the hall. No. Sometimes I walk by in his office, we just make eye contact, and I wave. That's about it.
He really has hair your length right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, maybe a little bit longer.
Like,
yeah.
Like a bob.
Yeah. Like a little bob. Like a Frank. Know. Like a fob.
I got to see that. I don't know what that means.
A Frank bob. A fob. Like the
Okay,
fob
Naboomer was so much better.
Okay,
that was your peak.
Right,
that was your peak right there.
That's the episode title. Okay, Naboomer. Shit. What else we got? How long are we going for?
About an hour.
Can we get this over with? No, I'm kidding. I can't think of it. I don't think I saw. What did I see this weekend? I was telling you earlier, Solo, I rewatched. Oh, that was great. That was one of my favorite bits last week.
Yeah, last week's show was so much better.
Wait, you watched Solo again?
Yeah, I rewatched it over the weekend.
Why?
Because I was like, watching Mandalorian, and I'm like, okay, this show's pretty cool. I'm like kind of getting ready for Skywalker, you know, getting in that Star Wars mood. I'm playing this new Star Wars game.
Mm-hmm. Well, you guys are caught up with Mandalorian?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
It's good.
It's good?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is my Star Wars that I've been waiting for.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Just putting that out there.
It's not just a ploy to sell Baby Yodas?
Oh, now maybe.
Okay.
I mean, it's working.
Yeah.
I want that fucking toy.
I want that baby.
Yeah. Amber keeps calling.
You don't even want your own baby.
Someone else make the joke for me. We see where this is going. Someone else do it.
Yeah.
So I don't have the words saying I don't
want your kid. Your kid can't do the force.
Cody, what did
yet.
You
hear
you say? Nothing at all. That was Brian's words. I'm in the clear.
It's good, though. They're definitely restraint. It's not like, I don't, they're not playing it safe, but they are. Like, the episodes are
that's
very.
What everything is of Star Wars.
True.
You can't. You
they're
can't,
just afraid.
Yeah, they're afraid
they're
to
not
piss
like,
off anybody.
They haven't, like, fully gone out there. Last, though, the third episode that they did was, like, the best one that they put out.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, like, some cool, like, even, like, deep lore shit that they're starting to bring out. But it's, like, it's nothing like, oh, my God. I was like, yeah, cool. All right.
That's what all the Star Wars seems like. You're like, okay, that's cool. Mm-hmm. It's it connects.
Dude, I'm fucking fine with that. You know, and if it blows my mind, great. Like, my expectations are, like, so low with everything at this point.
So low.
Woo! Nice.
Woo!
He's back. He was never gone,
oh,
but he's
man.
Back again.
No one's ever really gone.
Whoa! They say that
Star
in Last
quote.
Jedi.
Oh. Yeah.
It's another Star Wars.
Because it's
there's the new Star Wars, like, Last Skywalker. Is that not what it's called?
I really wish it was called The Last Skywalker now.
Grandpa Brian, did you see the Star Wars thing coming out?
What's the
new, Rise of
the
Skywalker.
Last Skywalker?
It looks like the Jedi. It looks like the same poster.
The Last
Jedi?
Yeah.
It's blue, though.
Yeah.
That's the difference.
Okay.
Aren't you sold? You're not going to see that opening weekend?
No. God damn it. It looks like the same movie from 2 years ago. It's just Rey and Finn Ren. The other guy.
Finn Ren.
They're just fighting. It looks like the same movie from two
years
ago.
Well, they got to conclude their fight.
In a blue hue.
With blue.
Instead of a red hue. Come on, Brad. It's a completely new movie. Come on.
It's going to be fine.
Yeah.
We're all going to forget about it.
The first one was a yellow hue, I remember. Maybe it was more of a teal.
Is that how it works?
Yeah,
Oh, the dawn.
You always got to change it up with a new hue.
And then the second one's the bad guy.
Yeah, like, oh no, it's going to end depressingly.
Then
yeah.
The third one is, what do you got? Oh my god, this guy makes himself crack up.
I thought you were laughing at that too.
I thought you were part of that too. Wait, so when does the Skywalker movie come out?
December 20th.
And they're already promoting it?
It's only like 3 weeks away, bro.
They've been promoting it all year.
Wow, well, shit. Plus in 4 weeks.
There's other movies coming out, Cody.
Like?
Irishman.
Mm.
Irish goodbye in that one.
Yeah.
They part.
Ford v. Ferrari.
Yeah. Don't see it if you got a Honda.
Yeah.
If you have a Ford, you get a discount. I don't know.
That'd be cool. To prove you drive a Ford.
Ferrari, you just get in for free.
Yeah.
You know, you don't need to buy it.
What kind of marketing is this? Not making a profit.
Come on down to Hamburg Ford.
You buy a Ford. You buy a Ford and you get a free ticket to the movie.
We're only on a Tuesday in the afternoon.
That'd be cool.
You can't go peak weekend.
A Ford of Oxnard. You buy pick up a Ford.
You're mad at that motherfucker. Like,
the rule in the valley.
The one guy's like, I bought a Ford, but you know what's the best part about it? I got to go see Ford v Ferrari for free.
That'd be cool.
Payment's $500 a month, but you do get to see a matinee on a Wednesday at Ford v Ferrari.
Oh, you don't get the golden ticket premium prices.
No, you can't even choose your seat. It just fucking goes for you.
There is a surcharge as well.
Fuck yeah.
Pay $4.50 to get
it's
in.
It's 2-drink minimum, by the way.
Yeah, of course. Comes with a popcorn that you have to buy.
Yeah. You get a little toy car Ford, though.
Yeah,
yeah, that's it. And a poster. Sorry, go ahead. What were you saying?
Oh, I've been catching up on the Disney Plus.
Oh, yeah.
Disney Plus.
Have you been watching any Disney Channel original movies? Are you staying clear?
I watched one.
Oh.
Am I not allowed to watch one?
I kind of want us to stay clear, but if you're watching one, maybe I'll watch one more.
I saw The Phantom of the Maker.
Oh, I will say right now.
Cody would like that one.
Oh, yeah, I think so too. But here's the thing. I made a post today on Patreon for them to vote.
Ahoy.
Wangers.
No, wrong one.
No, wrong one. It was for them to.
Ahoy.
Yeah, thank you. Mm-hmm. They had to vote on which of four movies.
Top four.
We're doing a commentary series, guys, on the Disney Channel original movies. All right, and he posted a poll with four movies from the Disney Channel.
Okay, can I guess the tops?
I'm going to white splain me. Yes, mm-hmm.
The top Disney Channel original movie.
Let's start with
movie.
The fourth one.
God damn,
let's do a power ranking. What do you think the fourth one is, Brian? Come on.
I would say I'm going to go with top is
no,
Brink.
No, we're going to go
top
four.
Top is Brink.
We're going to go four.
Brink was the top. I mean, in the list that I put, I didn't put it on top, but that was like the most requested one.
That people put.
Yes, Brink.
Wait, so you made a top four?
No. Okay. God damn it. So I made one post last week saying, what movies do you guys want us to watch? Yeah. And then a lot of people listed it. And then I made a poll of the four ones, and Brink is on there.
Brink was the top one or not the top one?
I didn't put like top one. Like,
no, the one people voted for the most.
They're the ones that voted for the most.
Brink's number one.
Brink is number one.
Well, okay.
Just say Brink is number one.
So far. So far, they're
just
okay.
Say Brink is the top one.
Now I know what you're saying. $1. But $3 if you want the commentaries. I see what you're saying now. Okay, yes.
Brink is the top one.
Okay, I was tripping out.
He was so like, I'm not going to.
Okay, hold on. I was tripping out because I did not put Brink on the top one.
Not acknowledge
on the actual,
that it's the top voted film.
It's the second one on there, but yes, it is the most voted for. And I know, but I was just really confused, okay?
What did you think he meant by top one? Literally the one on the very top.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Why would he in which you
about the arrangement of the movie?
I had a hard day today, okay? Leave me alone.
Has any idea what's going on?
They don't care. It doesn't matter. All right, so Brink is right now.
Voted. Say Brink is the top one.
As of right now, okay. Because people can still vote.
That's
Brink
the popular
is
one.
Yes, okay. That's the popular
the
one.
The most popular voted one.
Okay, what's the one below that you think is like close to it?
Yes, we're not starting at four. Okay.
That would be too hard.
Okay.
Because you gotta get rid of
the
top.
We already stopped at the top, and then we gotta go
to
the bottom.
So Brink is the top, and then I would say Alley Cat Strikes is two.
No, that's last right now. Only three people.
You should have started with four. I told you guys.
Fuck,
come on.
Wait, do you mean four?
In your order?
Do you mean four or the bottom
the
one?
The lowest voted of the four.
Not the one that's in number four slot.
No, of course
okay,
not.
Okay, but it is in the four slot.
It would have applied to both.
Okay, all right.
So that's the fourth one.
Correct.
Alley Cat Strike.
Both in the slot and the one voted for.
Number two, I would say Halloween Town.
No.
That's not on there?
No, it's not on there.
At all?
Mm-mm.
Halloween Town 2, Cavalier's Revenge.
Cavalier's Revenge.
Halloween, those are the top ones.
You're missing.
Did I say Smart House?
No, but you said one earlier.
Phantom of the Megaplex is on there?
That's close next to Brink right now.
That's number two?
That's right underneath Brink.
I watched that. Cody, you got to watch it.
I watched that one like last year because it's not really a whodunit, but you're trying to figure out who's the Phantom.
Well, yeah, it is.
But like no one's dying though. That's what I mean.
It's not a whodunit, but you're trying to figure out who done it.
Yeah.
What's
the
other
one? What's the third one?
Let me guess.
Come on, man. Guess you got like jizz on your head.
Do I?
Yeah.
From what?
What is that? It's like a string. Oh. You should have left it.
Oh, because I like went like this.
Okay.
Oh,
that's where you do it.
Let me see.
I think I cut my eye.
Halloween Town is not on there.
Correct.
Spider bite on my bike.
Holy shit. Whoa. Oh, okay. Easy guns.
Cody, I think easy. That's infected. Yeah.
Is that your way of just showing your fucking muscles?
Why would I want to show off my muscles?
My
no,
spider
I'm not
bite.
Even flexing, guys. Oh, God.
Oh, is that infected?
Yeah. Let's take a look at that. It's moving.
Oh, look at that.
What?
Oh, shit.
Oh, whoa.
Stuck on there. How is that stuck on there?
I don't know.
I'm keeping it there. That's good luck.
Is that magnetic? Is that bad for our ears?
Oh, I think it is.
Oh, it is magnetic.
Oh, it is.
Man.
It's not that strong.
So the third one.
The third one.
What a strange place to end this list.
Yes.
1, 4, 2, 3. If we want to just start
it's
at 4.
Star Wars way.
Can you guess what I'm doing?
Johnny Tsunami.
Yeah.
All right.
Johnny Tsunami. There's a white dude in that movie you would fucking love.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a snowboarder.
His name's probably Tucker.
There's a.
Oh, I don't know, actually. No. It could be.
There's a white guy in Phantom of the Megaplex where he's a bully and
his name's Tanner.
I don't know his name.
Oh, that sounds good. I think it could be.
But then he like he's like, get this nerd. And then he like high fives his bro. He's like, yeah.
So,
I'm looking forward to all these.
If you want
to
vote on those, patreon.com.
Any of them?
No.
Not a single.
I caught the end of Smart House the other day because my wife was watching it.
She knows what's up.
She's seen all of them.
She gets
mad at me when I tell her I haven't seen it.
You were deprived of all the Disney Channel original.
Would she want to do one with us?
I'm sure she would.
Oh, yeah. That'd be a lot of fun.
We can leave the kid at home.
We could do it with him there.
Give him a mic. Give him a headset. We'll give him a headset, Mike.
He's got daycare.
Yeah.
No, it's fine.
You know what's not
on? We could do Quince with this kid.
Oh, Quince.
Yeah.
Of course.
The girl from Halloween Town.
Yeah. Kimberly J. Brown.
Oh, sick. Mm-hmm.
I've been watching That's So Raven.
No. You?
I hate that show.
You, Cody? Whitey?
I didn't say that.
No, you implied it. She was watching that show, and I was like, oh, this is That's So Raven. Never watched that before either.
She's got visions.
I hate that show.
Why, Brian?
Zooms in on her eyeball.
Because she was like, I don't like the Raven is just so big and just a big character. Like everyone was just so like giant and cartoonish. I didn't like that. I like the more subdued.
Like a sitcom thing.
You're more of a Wizards of Waverly Place kind
Love
of
Wizards.
Guy. I like that show too, actually. That show
so
funny.
Weird is on there.
Dude, I've been dying to fucking watch. That show creeped me out. Yeah. So check weird. It out.
It's
so,
like the Twilight Zone, but for like teenagers.
Yeah. Oh. So it's like this family, they're all in a band and they go on tour with each other. But at night, they go ghost investigating and shit.
Oh, shit.
And every episode. That's reckless. Every episode, they're like, oh, that's so weird.
And they switch the lead girl. Like
halfway through.
In.
Oh, really?
It's so like
in mid season?
Did she?
No. What happened? Like character? The next season, like it was a blonde girl, and then the next season it was a brunette, or opposite.
You
whatever.
Know who's in that show?
Molly.
Molly? No,
I think that's the name of the name of the girl, the mom.
No, Eric Von Detten.
Yeah,
from Brink.
Yes, Brink.
You'll find out
you'll
soon
love
enough.
Brink.
We're in your commentaries for the entire.
Yeah. Damn. I'm excited for you to watch Brave.
Oh, man. We're going to watch all those movies, and then we're also just going to binge an entire show. just so weird.
Oh, you know what show they don't have on Disney Plus? The Jersey. Do you remember that movie?
Dude, was that was show? That, was that Fox?
That was Disney.
That was Disney?
I think so.
That's a great show.
Yeah.
You would like that show. Is that
about a basketball jersey?
No. I don't know if it was a basketball jersey, but
it was like a wool jersey.
He puts on the shoes.
Shoes, yeah. Make me like Mike. You're right. Trailer. It was Disney Channel.
They put on a jersey and they turn into the athlete.
I had heard of this.
Yeah.
Like Mia Hamm was in it.
Yeah, no, yeah. Like Phil Mickelson was in it. That's the only golfer I know.
What fucking kid wants to grow up to be Phil Mickelson?
They had the Monday Night Football.
Left
the
MNFC.
MNFC, the Monday Night Football Club.
Oh, jeez.
That's the only thing I searched for when I saw Disney Plus and it wasn't there.
I mean, how many? It was three seasons.
Yeah. Maybe they're a rights issue.
Using the likeness of all these people.
Yeah, I don't know if that's
it's all
issue.
Disney Channel. Oh, because of the sports peeps. Well, they own ESPN, though.
They own everything.
So they own the athletes, yeah, they can right?
Get, I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't know. But the Star Wars A New Hope commentary is dropping this Wednesday.
We're smack dab in the middle of the Star Wars commentaries. The Sith one just came out last week.
That was
a fun one. That's my favorite one so far.
Yeah, I'm glad no one was there for Attack of the Clones because that was just... Sorry, Robert. That was just miserable. We were both...
That movie's not good.
No, it's not. It's really not. But we had a good time. Revenge of the Sith and A New Hope was a lot of fun.
That was a good one.
Is the sand thing in Attack of the Clones?
Okay, yeah. And then actually, we're gonna release the A New Hope on Wednesday because it's Thanksgiving, so you guys get a little bit early. So yeah, there you go. Happy Thanksgiving. Yeah, happy Thanksgiving. Yeah. Gobble gobble, bro. Gobble gobble, motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Gobble gobble with a lowercase b.
Yes,
bruh.
It's gobble. I don't know. So that'll be out this week. And then more news on the short film. If you're on Patreon right now, you've already seen the teaser trailer. You already know the title.
You know what it's called.
You know who's in it. And that's about it. So I think right now people are asking, we're looking for a December release date. I mean, that's the end of the year. So that's what we're coming down to. And for regular peeps, I'm sure the teaser trailer will drop on Twitter at some point this week or next week. So...
Get excited.
Also, I'm catching up on a lot of Boy Meets World episodes.
I started watching that, and that first episode is rough.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
the pilots of every episode are terrible.
Terrible, okay. Yeah. I almost want to skip, because I actually liked it when they got older, and it got more dramatic and stuff. I almost just want to skip all over the kids' shit and get to the real stuff.
I watched the episode where Sean joins a cult. Do you remember that episode?
Oh, no, I don't remember that one.
Yeah, you guys remember that?
No, I don't think he didn't watch any
Boy Meets World.
No,
that wasn't Disney. That was ABC.
I didn't watch it.
What the fuck is wrong with you, Cody?
Sorry,
they got in Corona over there. Telemundo.
Yeah, they do. Actually, I learned a lot about television back then.
They were in Riverside. A lot of Telemundo out there.
But now quality television.
He joins a cult because like he's empty. He has no parents, and the guy's like, "Come to the center. We'll center you." And it's really it gets cult
centered. Do you remember the Halloween episode where there's like a killer in the? I rewatched that one. Yeah, that was Whodunit. Guess who was in it?
Linda Cardellini.
No. Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. It's good stuff.
Yeah. They were all, like, Eric was, like, making out with her. Like,
full on. Like, just, oh, no, not gonna, okay, just gonna do that.
Yeah, yeah. Right.
Yeah, he was my favorite because, like, he plays it straight when he's, like, younger, but then when they get to a certain age and they just turn him into the idiot. Like, he's just a total fucking moron.
Well, he, like, it's kind of an evolution
Yeah.
Because, like, like he is dumb, like, during the high school seasons. He's like, yeah, I'm going to this. I'm going to Beach State.
Yeah.
Like, for college. And then he's like, you just get it. That's not a real. They're like, that's not a real place. They're like, tell that girl. Do you think she's going to Duke over there? Great jokes, man.
Classic.
Oh. Yeah. And I'm watching another. I was in the middle of another movie.
Well, you have a lot of time to watch everything but The Mandalorian.
Huh? Mandalorian sucks.
It's like 30 minutes of short episode.
Fuck The Mandalorian.
You can watch them all in an hour and a half.
Come on, man.
I'll be home for Christmas with Jonathan Taylor Thomas.
Oh.
You guys didn't watch that?
No, I didn't see that
God
one.
God damn it, Cody. Where are my white friends?
I remember the ultimate Christmas present.
When you need them.
The ultimate Christmas present.
The snow. Yeah. The snow machine.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I watched Snow Day. It's a good movie.
I think that's Nickelodeon.
It is.
That is Nickelodeon.
I was a Nick kid.
Ah, wow.
So you're going to get the new Nickelodeon app?
Maybe I will.
Okay.
Shit.
Oh, you're going to watch SpongeBob now?
Maybe I will.
Oh, man.
Go see Wild Thornberries. Rats.
Oh, man.
Who did the voice of the dad?
I think we've talked about this.
We probably have.
I don't remember.
Smashing. Yeah. It's Tim Curry.
Tim Curry.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hello, Huggy.
I thought you were talking about the dad in Rugrats.
Oh.
Stu.
Yeah.
What was the doctor's name in Rugrats?
Lipshits. Yeah. Dr. Lipshits.
I always laughed at that as a kid. I shouldn't have known.
He looked like a conehead, too. It was really weird.
Did he
looked creepy. Yeah. He was
Remember when Chucky's dad remarried?
Yeah. Yeah.
It wasn't all grown up.
To Paris.
Yes. Oh, Rugrats in Paris.
Yeah, the movie.
Oh,
I didn't see that
When Chucky finally speaks. Oh my God, that's a powerful cinematic moment. Yeah, that's.
What do you mean he speaks?
So
you know they don't speak in front of the parents.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
And the first time he speaks is when he kicks in the fucking doors to this wedding chapel to stop his dad's wedding from happening.
And he says like, no.
He's like Chucky's first word.
Mm-hmm. Oh
yeah,
yeah.
I haven't seen that one.
Oh dude, it's fucking one. That's when that's how Kimmy gets introduced in the show. His stepsister Kimmy. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, because he marries
too
like
busy
her.
Watching Boy Meets World.
Yeah,
I saw the first Rugrats, but I think I was already like 15
when Paris came out. Ting tang, walla walla, bing bang. Ooh ee, ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla, bing bang.
No Reptar or anything like that.
I watched. Wait, what
Reptar.
Do you mean? There was a movie called Reptar.
No, I mean like that was the.
Yeah, I watched
you're familiar
Rugrats.
With it.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I watched the show growing up.
Okay,
but once it got to Paris, I think I was too old for that.
I loved it. Was that the one where they? Was the Reptar like little cart in the first
movie?
Yeah,
it was like a ride or some shit.
I remember there was an actual like little cart that they rode around in. I don't remember which movie that was though. It's good shit. Love that stuff. I saw that first movie in theaters.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I did. One way or another.
Yeah. Well,
I was 10. Rugrats in Paris, the movie. It was 2000.
You were too old for Rugrats.
I think I was
when you
too
were 10.
Old at that
you had All Grown Up? Fuck it.
I didn't watch All Grown Up.
No?
No.
With you!
I didn't care for it.
Come on.
They all still had really big heads. It creeped me out. Like really skinny bodies, too.
Yeah. That was just strange.
I would have much rather loved a All Grown Up for Rocket Power.
Oh, Rocket Power was dope.
That would have been dope.
They were riders on a mission. They were.
Dun, 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 dun.
Play that theme song. That's okay.
Wiggity, 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 wiggity. Yeah. What do they call people with shoes on the beach?
What do they call
it? You don't know?
Shoobies. Oh, okay. Took me a second.
Oh, some guys, fan of Nickelodeon.
20 years since I've watched the show.
Did you watch it?
My favorite joke from that show, this is proof I watched it, was when Raimundo was talking to a customer at the restaurant, and she's like, is a fish taco shaped like a fish? He's just like, sure, whatever. Is that what you want? It was so funny. He's like,
that's
no, I'll have a cheeseburger.
Do you remember what was their he wasn't their uncle, but he was
Tito.
Like Tito. Yeah.
On a mission.
Do you remember the episode when he was doing hot burgers?
No.
It was a hot dog and a hamburger bun.
What episode is that when he's like, whatever you want?
I don't remember. It was so funny though, because the customer keeps annoying him. He's like, yes, sure, whatever.
Thank you so much, everybody, for watching this episode of Wangers. This is episode 143.
Yep.
Did I say that last time?
Yep.
This was the nostalgia trip, the nostalgia pills, if you will, episode. And we had a really great time. Hope you love playing along with us, because that's a game I think we need to bring back every single
week. Yeah, more nostalgia games.
What the Rush, what's his name, from Silicon Valley.
Rustfest.
There's a wide library we can play there.
Must be a little rusty. Thank you all for watching or listening this episode of Wangers. This episode's brought to you by Hot Durgers. The a hot dog within a hamburger bun. Yeah, it doesn't make any sense, but you'll dig it. We're on Anchor, Spotify, Apple Podcasts. Check us out. Subscribe. Rate, review, subscribe to this channel, Amateur Art Films. Be on the lookout for a brand new short film within the next few weeks. It's very exciting. And, I don't know, Patreon, patreon.com/wangers, where you can find a bunch of cool stuff, working on some new things for next year. Closer to the, now we're getting close to the end of the year, boys. Mm. We got some goals to make, to meet.
Slim up.
This is the week. This is the month to do it.
To start?
Yeah.
To start.
Start those resolutions.
Yeah, you know, let's start that. Let's start our goals for 2020 right fucking now.
Fuck that. That's stressing me out.
All right. Fine. Mm-hmm. Who cares? Yeah. Thanks, everybody. Appreciate you. Happy Thanksgiving. Hope everybody has a wonderful, wonderful turkey day. Drive safe. Traffic here in LA is going to suck. Dude! And if you're in a state that has shitty weather, I'm sorry. We're going to get rained on. That's about it.
Oh, we're going to get rain here.
That's what I just said.
Oh. All right.
I'm only happy when it rains. It's a good song. Right there?
All right. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. The best holiday of the year besides Halloween. Hit that shit! So you told us about a White Christmas.
Yeah.
For the longest time, did you think that was The Offspring?
No.
Listen to it again. It sounds like
it
The Offspring.
A little bit, as you say, yeah.
What's a White Thanksgiving?
Same thing.
It's Cody's house.
Same thing.
Okay.
Mostly white. Mostly white.
Now, you don't like Thanksgiving.
I hate Thanksgiving. It's my least favorite of the year-end holidays.
Ever been to a White Christmas?
Yeah. Any bad one of those? I'm doing another bingo card this year.
Oh.
Stay tuned for that, guys.
Woo!
It'll be fun.
Do you have it written out yet or no?
Not yet. No, I'll probably figure out the day of
it. What is it? Let me guess.
Well, it's a podcast.
How's the baby doing?
How's the baby doing?
You get enough sleep?
You guys having another one? Yeah. There'll be another one.
Yeah.
How's work? What do you do?
Yeah, what do you do again?